What we can also do now is to check if the player cycling works. So right now we are player 0. Continue. And if I click again, I am still player 0. And that's because I'm returning false. I'm quite stupid. Okay. So now we need to check if this point is on any column. So let's first check if the let's go for each check individually. So for column int column unsigned int, sorry, I will start this by 0 now. Smaller column count. Count column plus plus. And we should check for the side for the height first. So let's check if it's within our current size. So if transformed location dot y is bigger than or equal to zero, or in the end, it's end. Transformed location y is smaller than or equal to our row count times our cell height, then we are going to check if we are hitting any column. This is really efficient, even though it doesn't have to be. Because it's so few checks. I could run this like 2,000 times on the PC simultaneously. Which might be good if we make a massively multiplayer version of this. But you're not, hopefully. Okay, so let's check. Let's get the float expose. Let's get the transformed location.x into a local variable and check if expose is bigger than or equal to our column times the cell width and our x position is smaller than our column times cell width plus cell width, then we will return true. And also we need to push coin. That's like still to do. Let's just check if we can determine the correct column. So the column should be like the index column click on. So if I click on the first one, there should be 0. Column 0. And if I click the second one, I should be at 1. Yes. And I should now also be player 1. Yes. If I continue, I'm now player 0 again. If I click the last one, we will get 6, right? 6, yes, this works. This works, and we are player 2. Continue. And if we click somewhere else, like around this shit, we are not inserting anything. So, yeah. That's working. Now we need to persist our level data. So we need to somehow store where the coins have been inserted before. And first of all, we want to have a function for actually inserting things. So let's call this bool, and then persist coin, and we will get the unsigned int column and the int player. And we also need the level data now. So how do we... Also, there's no music. Where is my music? I want my music. Can I just play? Let's just start from the start again. Ooh. I really like music. I actually discovered it only a couple days ago. I mean, I knew it was there long before, but I thought there was only crap in there, the audio library. Okay, so how do we store our level data? I guess we need some sort of column info. I'd like to have something like an array, but arrays are so weird. Vectors are nice. I think a vector is good. But not in like this vector. STD vector? Yes! And I want a vector of a vector of a of an int level. Ta-da! Now we're done. So the first vector, or the inner vector with the int, is like a single column. That makes sense. So at each, if we have one of these, this will be a column, and to have a vector of columns, because we have multiple columns, we have a vector of int. I like it, I like it. So let's persist the coin. And in order to do that, we will do this now. Okay, so let's check, first of all, if level oh, the thing is, I don't know how to initialize this thing. Do I need to initialize this? I think so. Yeah, I guess I need to initialize it. So let's initialize it in our constructor, which is in here. And let's initialize it for int, unsigned int, god. Unsigned int, column 0, column less than column count level dot pushback. And then we push back a std vector dot int, and that's going to be empty. There we go, and we need to increase our column. So this way we can access this column dot is there like a size? Yes, size. Size less than row count. Then we can insert it, and we will insert it by level column. And then just push back the player, right? Return true. So if the column is not filled up yet, we will add another thing there. I think that's correct. Let's just see. We need to go in here to set the breakpoint again. Oh, and we need to call it, of course. So if persist coin on column of player, I can actually just return the result of that. So let's just return this. If the column is full, then we just do nothing and the player is still there. So we will return false, so the player is still on his turn. If that makes any sense. So, I guess it's time to test again. Let's run this. And if I click on the second column now, we insert this. And if I click on this again, we insert this again. We will play one now. And I'd like to know if we can see. Yeah, there we go. Okay, we put two things in there now. And I want to know what happens if I put too much in there. So, four, right? Oh, that's the fifth already. And now the six. So this is effectively full now, I think. We can see that... wait, what's with the player? Oh, what the fuck? The player just is just increasing. How is that? That's really weird. No, it's always true. So we set the player to the player plus one. Do I need to put it like this? Recompiling. I love it. I love this part about working with C++ right now. You just change things. So if I click on this, it's no longer working, but if I click on this, it works again, and we are now player 0 again, finally. And player 1. Player 0. Yeah, it works. Okay, all we have to do now is to actually draw the coins. Should be too hard, right? Let's draw them points. Let's take a look at this. We need to draw the coins. Turn-based coin insertion. This works. And now draw coins. Draw the coins.